Hello students, welcome to LFI Educates. This is your fourth chapter of grade 12 mathematics, and in this chapter we shall discuss about determinants. So before coming to this chapter determinants, you must have clear conception of matrices, and then we shall see what are determinants. Okay, so basically determinants are a real number. That means to every matrices that you have got, we can assign a real value to that matrix. Okay, so once we apply the determinant rule, we shall get a real number as a result. So basically, where do we use the determinants? We use it to find the area of a triangle, or basically we use the determinants to find solution of system of equations or system of linear equations. So you have got equations like a1x plus b1y is equal to c1, a2x plus b2y is equal to c2 in your grade 10. How have you solved them? There were many processes: elimination method, cross multiplication method, substitution method. So these things can also be solved by using determinant. Like if we want to write these equations in the matrix form, how can we write them? We can write them a1, b1, a2, b2, only writing the coefficients. And here we shall have x, y, and here the constant, that is c1 and c2. And if we are able to solve this matrix, then we shall get the value of x and y. Fine? Now, when these two equations will have a unique solution, or they are consistent or inconsistent. Like in your grade 10, you have got a result that a1 by a2, if it is not equal to b1 by b2, then the solutions of x and y, or the solutions of this linear system of linear equation, is unique. Now from this thing we get a result, like if it is equal, then we can write a1 b2 minus b1 a2, isn't it, bringing the b1 b2 in the left hand side of the equal to. So what does this give? This is a number, isn't it? If we multiply a1 b2 minus b1 a2, we shall get some value. So that will be a real number, isn't it? So actually this is the determinant, this is the value of the matrix, or we can say the determinant of the matrix. So in other form we can write this as a1 b2 and here b1 a2. So we cross multiply it, like a1 b2 minus a2 b1. Fine. So this is all about the determinant, and we represent the determinant how? Either by this, don't confuse it with the modulus sign. This is actually the determinant. If the inside thing is matrix, if the A is a matrix, then if we give this sign, that means two lines, so it will be the determinant. Or else we can define it by this triangle, okay, or delta. Okay, so there are certain kind of determinants. Like if you have a matrix A having element only one, say A1, then there is a matrix of order 1 and the determinant of A will be A1 itself, the same thing. Now if here it is, this matrix was of order 1. Now if a matrix is of order 2, say A1 A2 or A1 A2 B1 or A1 1 A1 2 A2 1 A2 2, so that will be better. Now if we have a matrix like this, how to find the determinant? Just this is a matrix of order 2 by 2, so in that case we must take A1 1 into A2 2, this 2, minus A2 1 into A1 2 into this 2. Fine. Okay, what about the if the matrix is of order 3 by 3, then what? If a matrix is of order 3 by 3, so suppose A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. So in such a case, we need to expand the matrix with respect to either row 1 or row 2 or row 3 or column 1 or column 2 or column 3. So we need to expand the matrix using the second order matrix. Okay, so how to do, I shall show you. And before going to that, one thing to be remembered is that whenever we are finding the determinant of a matrix, the very thing that needs to be considered is that the matrix should be a square matrix. If a matrix is having an order of 3 by 4 or 5 by 2, we cannot find the determinant of such matrix. It must be square always. Okay. Proceeding to the previous matrix that was of order 3 by 3, if we want to find the determinant, suppose this is the determinant, how to find it? We can expand it, say, let us expand it with respect to the first row. Then what? At first right, minus 1 to the power, you see the suffix. Here it is 1, 1. That means you need to write 1 plus 1 here. Okay? Along with the coefficient, that is A11. And what you need to multiply, or which determinant you need to write here? A22 into A33 minus A32 into A23. Fine? Okay. Now, take this one, this element, plus minus 1 to the power. We have here A12, so it will be A1 plus 2. Then the coefficient A12 along with. Now, don't skip this row and this column and write these elements. That is A21 into A33 minus A31 into A23. Fine? Plus minus 1 to the power. Here we have A13. So 1 plus 3 and along with the suffix that will be A13. So it will be, skip this row and this column, so we shall be left with A21, A32. It will be A21 into A32 minus A31 into A22. A31 into A22. So this will be the determinant of this matrix. Now clearly we can see that minus 1 to the power 1 plus 1, that is 2. This will give us a positive number. So we shall be left with A11, A22 into A33 minus A32 into A23. And 2 plus 1 will be 3. So this will be this will be an odd number. So minus 1 q will be minus of A12 into A21, A33 minus A31, A23. Plus, here 3 plus 1 will be 4, so this will be a positive quantity, and this will be A13 into A21 into A32 minus A31 into A22. So this is how we find the determinant of a 3 by 3 matrix. Now we have, in this case we have taken this particular row, that is row 1. We can also take this row, or we can take this column, or we can take this column. So this will actually depend on the situation in which it is much more easier. But remember that in all the cases, the answer will always be same. Fine? So we shall do a few examples in our coming exercises, and then we'll be very clear. In different problems, we shall take different rows or columns according to our problem. Okay. So this is how we find the determinants of various matrices. Now let us see exercise 4.1, a question from there, that is question number 2.1 I have considered. So we need to find the determinant of cos theta and minus sine theta and cos theta. So how to find the determinant of this? Just since it is a matrix of order 2 by 2, so here, I'm doing it directly. So multiply cos theta with sine, this cos theta, that will be cos square theta. And here we have minus sine theta into minus sine theta. So this will give us cos square theta plus sine square theta is equal to 1. A very easy example of finding determinant. Let us see question number 4. Question number 4 says that if A is equal to 1 0 1 0 1 2 0 0 4, then show that determinant of 3A is equal to 27 determinant of A. Fine. So how to do this? Here we have A is equal to this, isn't it? I'm doing it directly. Solution. Here we have A is equal to this. Then we need to show that determinant of 3A is this. Fine. Now at first let us find what is 3A. Since this A is a matrix, so if I multiply a scalar with this, it will be 3 0 3 0 3 6 0 0 and 4 3 12. Fine. Now what we need to find? Determinant of 3A. Therefore determinant of 3A will be equal to, okay, so how to find the determinant here? That means which row or column we need to consider, since it is a 3 by 3 matrix. So which one to consider? Okay, let me write it first. 3 0 3 0 3 6 0 0 12, and that will be equal to, now you see that these two are 0, isn't it? And this is a number. That means if we take the first column, it will be very easy for us because we do not need to calculate these two cases. Okay, so if we have 3 here, and then we need to take the determinant of 3 2 3 6 0 12, and others will be minus 0 and plus 0, as I have explained in previously. So this will give us 12 into 3 36, and 6 into 0 will be 0. So this will give us 8 39 108. Okay, so thus we have got determinant of 3A is equal to 108. So let me write it here. Determinant of 3A is equal to 108. Fine. Now let us find what is determinant of A. So determinant of A, let us see. It will be 1 0 1 0 1 2 0 0 4. So in the first column, here we can see that the first here both these numbers are 0, so it is better to take the first column, expand it with respect to the first column. So we shall have here 1 into determinant of 1 2 0 4. That means except this row and this column, whatever things are remaining, we need to write it here, minus 0 plus 0, because this number is 2 1, odd number, so it will be minus, and this is 3 1, so even number, so it will be plus here. Now this will give us 4 into 1 is 4, and 2 into 1 is 0. Fine. So this will give us 4 only. Now 27 into determinant of A. So this will be equal to what? 27 into 4. So 7, 4, 28, 2, 4, 2, 8, 9, 10. So you are getting 108, isn't it? So therefore we can say determinant of 3A is equal to 27 into determinant of A. Very easy, isn't it? So let us see another problem from the same exercise. So question number 5, you can try it yourself. It will be a very good exercise for you. Roman 1 2 3 4. And let us see question number 7. In question number 7, number 1 2 4 5 1 is equal to twice x, 4 6 x. So we need to find the values of x. How to do? At first find the determinant of the LHS. Here left hand side LHS is equal to 2 4 5 1, and what is that? Find the determinant, since it is a determinant of order 2 by 2. So simply multiply them. 2 into 1 minus 5 into 4. So this will give us 2 minus 20, and that will be equal to minus 18. Fine. Now what about the RHS? Here RHS is equal to twice x into 4, 6x. Now similarly, take the determinant of this. So it will be twice x into x minus 6 into 4. So this will leave us with twice x square minus 6424. Fine. Now in the given question, it is said that these two determinants are equal. So if two determinants are equal, then these two will also be equal, isn't it? So according to question, 2x square minus 24 is equal to minus 18. And this gives us 2x square minus plus 18 minus 24 is equal to 0. I can cancel out the 2's. It will be x square plus 9 minus 12 is equal to 0. Fine. Now, let us find it out, since it is a quadratic equation. So x square, sorry, we can easily find it out from here itself. So it will be x square minus 3 is equal to 0. So our value of x will be plus minus root 3. Okay. So this will be our question number 7. So this will be the end of this video. And in the next video, we shall come up with exercise 4.3 and various other problems. And one more thing is that CBSE has reduced the part, that is properties of determinants. So no need to go through that. And if anyone is interested, you can contact me directly. I shall provide you the notes for that, or I shall explain you separately. And so fine, till then, stay home and stay safe. Thank you.